gentlemen, Gordon Brown stood up in the Commons yesterday and said that this strike couldn't, there were no winners. What's your reaction to that?
Well, our reaction to that is there is no winners in that industrial action. We want a negotiated settlement that deals with the people issues and gets us back to work and treats these people with dignity and respect.
This isn't really about money, is it? This is about conditions, isn't it?
It's about conditions. It's about conditions. There is a pay rise. We had a pay freeze. But it's not really about that. It's about terms and conditions, bullying and harassing of the workforce, and just getting back to work and doing what we want to do is deliver a letter and so that we don't cause our the public any undue stress, so to speak.
There's been a lot of talk about, I've heard bullying used quite a lot, something on the radio this morning talked about bullying. What do you mean by that?
Bullying in respect of we had duties imposed on us by management, senior management, where there are people here, there's 16 people on this site here that haven't got jobs. People with lots of years service that have not been given jobs. Jobs were picked out of a hat. You've got people here with a couple of years service that have obviously been put on good jobs. People with lots of service that have got nothing and not even got a job. And we don't know how we're going to deal with them 16 people that have not got jobs.
What would it take for you to walk back in the doors today?
What we're asking for is a negotiated settlement that deals with the issues, the people issues and our terms and conditions. Modernisation, people say that we've not modernised. Let me tell you on here, we've gone down from 200 drivers, this is predominantly a driving section, we have got an indoor section as well. We've gone down from 200 drivers down to now 92 drivers. We now work weekends, we now work bank holidays at no extra money. We've got double deck trailers here that are taking driving jobs out all the time, and they're still saying that we're not modernising. That is totally unfair. We are modernising and have been for some while.
Yeah, we're not scared of modernisation at all. Not scared at all. We'll go, we'll embrace the new equipment. Not a problem at all.
Hopefully this isn't going to drag out and drag out. Is it just on site for 2 days this time, is that right?
Well, we're out today and the delivery part of the business is out tomorrow. I mean, this is our 15th day of action here, so we've been out on strike since June. So we've got to a point where we've got to carry on now.
Where are we in the negotiating at the moment? I mean, talks at ACAS, are they predominant? Are they happy?
Well, I don't think ACAS have got involved yet. Our national executive want to get ACAS involved, but the business want to put strings on the talks before they get ACAS involved. So that's where we are.
I mean, some will say that you've lost the letter business because of email, because the internet's come along. But also, the internet's brought huge benefits for the Royal Mail,
parcels and eBay, etc. I mean, the parcel side of the business is huge. I mean, there's so much work in there, parcel-wise. Even letters. I mean, we're coming up to Christmas there. There's Christmas cards and everything. So everyone's saying the letter business is dying. There's still a lot of work in the system. Our postmen out there, they are delivering more work now than they ever have done. It's just not right to say that there's no work in there. I think the business do massage figures when they talk about how much traffic they've lost.
Some will also say that, even those who agree with what you're doing, say this is suicide race. You're going to lose your jobs anyway if you do this. Was there no other course of action you could take?
Well, I think sometimes you get pushed into a corner where, I mean, what can we do? You know, we don't want to lose money. We're all here to earn money. We all want to look after the service, look after the public. But sometimes you just get pushed into a corner by bullying management, and you've got to come out and fight for your conditions.
So basically, at the end of the day, this is all down to cost cutting, isn't it? Really?
What, for the business side of things? Yeah. Definitely. Yeah.
So, the immediate, in your eyes, you and your colleagues are sitting out here this morning in the cold. You want talks to get started as soon as possible?
Yeah, I think that at the end of the day, a lot of fingers have got to be pointed at the government, because basically they're not getting involved and they need to get involved. And you've got to wonder, what's their agenda? They're obviously looking at trying to, I don't know, maybe sell the business, and they're trying to cut costs and maybe make the business look more attractive for someone to come in, TNT maybe, to buy the business. You know, because maybe they don't want it anymore as a public service. And we've got to look after it and make sure the public get the service they deserve.